As powerful as it sounds, Apple Intelligence is not here, at least for another couple of months. But there are several other features that are equally powerful and is available now in macOS Sequoia that will even replace some of the third-party apps and make you an instant Power Mac user. Before we get into it, these are the list of devices that support the latest macOS Sequoia. Now, let's get to it. The first feature on the list is the Continuity feature. Continuity feature lets you mirror your iPhone remotely on your Mac. Right after you update, you will see this icon on your dock. Click it remotely to connect your iPhone. It works if your iPhone is with you or if it's in a bag across the room or even in a standby mode. Scrolling on your trackpad or mouse will translate as a one-finger swipe gesture. If you have a regular mouse without multi-touch, you can also click and drag to swipe. Hover your mouse near the top of the screen to bring up window controls and a toolbar. You can click on the home bar to go home, or you can click the home screen and app switcher buttons in the top right. Notifications from your iPhone will also appear as a banner on your Mac, and you can even click on these banner notifications and go into the respective app on your iPhone from your Mac. I'm not sure if this is a good feature in terms of productivity, but hey, it lets you do that. Next up on the list is tiling windows. The biggest pain for macOS, at least for me, has been the window management. Now, finally, without any third-party apps like Rectangle or Magnet, we can finally drag and drop windows to any site to snap them in place. And the best part of this is we can also assign keyboard shortcuts to this. In settings, you can set up shortcuts yourself. You can go to settings, keyboard, keyboard shortcuts, app shortcuts, and assign them a name and a combination of keys as a shortcut. If you want to set a shortcut to snap to the right, name it as right and assign the keys. If you go further into the settings to desktop and dock, by default, tiled windows have a small getter around them. You can disable this there. Scroll down to the windows section and uncheck tiled windows have margins. Here, you can also disable window snapping at the edge of the screen. Overall, this is a very solid update. I think this is enough for anyone, including the most demanding Power Mac users. Next up on the list is FaceTime. FaceTime gets a bunch of new features and updates this time. First notable update is now you can share your screen during a call and also choose which window to share. Good morning, Apple. All the third-party apps has been doing this forever. Also, you can give remote access to someone to take control over your Mac. This is great if you're someone who ends up giving tech support to your family and friends. My favorite update here is the presenter mode, which lets you share your screen while you're still visible on the side from your camera feed. You can also pick which side your screen share is shown. And also, the sidebar now includes live captions. The familiar iCloud password keychain now gets a dedicated app. The new passwords app makes storing, looking up, editing, or searching your saved passwords easier than ever. Before, the passwords were buried somewhere in the settings and looking them up was a tedious process. This is really a step forward, but still a step behind the dedicated password managers like 1Password, mainly because this is tightly coupled with Apple's ecosystem. So if you are using a Windows desktop, you cannot sync your iCloud keychain passwords to your desktop, but still a step forward for someone who hasn't used a dedicated password manager yet. Next on the list is AI summaries. This feature works much better on email summaries or summarizing text. Before, you have to send them into ChatGPT or other AI models, but now you can use it inbuilt. If you're using any native apps like Mail or Notes, when you highlight the text, it shows a little icon on top to show all that it can do. I thought this feature might work only on native apps, but turns out I was wrong. You can literally highlight any text on any third-party app and right-click and go into writing tools to get the same options as before. This is huge because a lot of third-party tools like Grammarly, Notion, they all charge a premium in order to use this AI summarizing features, but now it's going to be a hard sell. But still, this won't replace anything like ChatGPT or other similar models because you cannot ask or prompt the AI to do something for you. So that might change once you have Apple Intelligence or the next versions of Siri comes out. In theory, it should be capable of doing a lot more stuff than ChatGPT or other models, simply because it has a lot more system data on you. So I will do a full review on Apple Intelligence once it's released. So stay subscribed to see when it comes out. Besides this, there are a couple of other new small updates as well. One of them being the new focus mode. There's a new focus mode called Reduce Interruptions. So by leveraging AI, if you're in sleep or do not disturb mode, instead of not letting any notifications get to you, it analyzes the message of the notification and decides whether to show it to you or not. Next major update is Notes app. The dedicated team behind Apple Notes continues to deliver rich features this year. You can now record voice memos with transcription straight into your notes. There is collapsible section headers that make longer notes more browsable. You can now type out equations and calculations for solving longer form math problems dynamically. You can now highlight and color text in pink, purple, orange, mint, and blue. And if you record a call on your iPhone, a transcription will sync to your notes on your Mac as well as in a new call recording folder. The next app that got some major updates is Safari. Safari now has a feature called Reader Mode, which can summarize a page instantly by clicking the button next to the URL bar. It will tell you the gist of a long article right at the top, and you can click on a section to jump to a specific part. There's also something called information highlights, which will show up on certain pages. If you're looking at a business, restaurant, or a point of interest known to Apple Maps, you will see a widget that tells you the operating hours, contact info, and location. And you can click on the maps to open up the direction to that specific location. Articles will also have a summary with key points at the top. The caveat here with reader mode is that when you switch to reader mode, a lot of these websites that comes with all the affiliate ads disappear. It hides all the distracting elements like ads and shows you the key summary of the entire web page. I wonder how this will affect all the online bloggers that shows ads on their website and thus makes affiliate income. Let me know your thoughts in the comments below about how the reader mode is going to shape the affiliate marketing world in the future. Some of the major updates that we went over today, including the new Notes app, the new Passwords app, and the one I did not mention here today, the new iMessage message scheduling update, is all an overlap between the new iOS 18 and macOS Sequoia. So I did a dedicated video on all the iOS 18 features you should try over here. So I will catch you over there.